So who wants to teach, like, someone under the age of, I don't know, 12 on how to cook? Behind that plate is some kidney steaming. Anyways, greetings and welcome to Cooking in the Kitchen. Today we're making this steak and kidney pie with roasties and cabbage and pie. So yeah, we've got quite a lot to be made. Let's get started. But as I said, the kidney is heating in that pan.
Is
both
it?
The steak and the kidney.
Slightly
the steak and kidney
pudding.
And yeah, it's on low. Okay, so, and obviously before that, to put the roasties, the roast potatoes, into the oven, and they can take a different amount of time that is varying. I'm just chilling, watching American TV. Got all steak and kidney pudding, so now it's done. And now we've got the cabbages in the pan and we're waiting for it to boil. And after that, it should only take about 5 minutes or so, I believe. It's pretty much done. Our steak and kidney pudding's been done for quite a while. We're just leaving it in the pan because it will stay quite hot. And the cabbage, we're just pouring the water out of it into the jug. And you know what that means. We're making gravy out of the water stuff just to add the flavour a bit. Of course, you don't have to and you can do what you want. But we're making gravy, of course. And roasties, the roast potatoes are done too. Oh, gravy modules in that one. Stirring them, obviously. Oh, gravy's a bit too thin, so we're eating it into the microwave. I can pronounce it right now. I've said microwave. I have took the make out of Nigella. And yeah, we're leaving it in for 30 seconds. Well, it's probably about 15 now. Welcome to the summary! So to make this steak and kidney pudding with roast potatoes and veg and gravy, then you will take some roasties, roasted potatoes, and then yoink them in the oven. And it varies in how long it takes, but for us it didn't take until all the other food were done. And then about 7 minutes after you put the roasties in the oven, roast potatoes obviously, then you take the steak and kidney pudding, plop it on the pan on low, and then leave it to steam, obviously, and we put the plate over it. And then, that should take about 20 minutes, then once that was sorted, we just left it in the pan and turned the heat off as it would stay hot anyway. Then, we tipped the cabbage into another pan, left that for 5 minutes, and then, took the pan and carefully poured all the water out into a jug, and then tipped the cabbage into a sieve-looking thingy-bob. But it wasn't a sieve, just a plate bowl with holes in it. Don't know what it's called, though. But, yeah, and then with that cabbage water, you can use that to add the flavour of the cabbage into the gravy by adding the gravy granules to it and obviously stirring. And if it's too thin, then you can let it thicken a little bit by putting it in the microwave for 30 seconds, as we had to do. And obviously if it's thick enough, then hooray, you've just got the gravy sorted in there. If it's too thick, then it's easy to resolve. I think you just stir it a bit more. And then you take the cabbage out of the pan, plop that on the plate, take the steak and kidney pudding and eat that onto the plate, and take the roast, and obviously take the roasties out of the oven, plop that onto the plate, and then pour on the gravy, and you're done. Thank you guys for watching this episode of Cooking in the Kitchen, and I will see you next week. We're making these episodes a lot more inconsistently now. We're currently on once a week making these. Still quite a few months ahead though.